Welcome to 4C Kids Sunday School! Our big picture question for this unit is, why did Jesus perform miracles? Jesus performed miracles to show that he is the Son of God. Let's watch our Bible story to learn more.
Hello friends, it's me, Megan, and I'm Jesse.
Jesse, tell me about these things you have on your arms.
Oh yes, these are my floaties.
Nice, those are great to wear when you were learning to swim.
Yeah, I don't have to be afraid of sinking when I wear these.
In today's Bible story, Peter actually began to sink into the sea.
Oh no, he needed some floaties.
Peter had something even better than floaties.
He did? What?
Jesus. Listen to the Bible story to hear what happened.
Jesus had been teaching people by the sea. It was getting late, so he told his disciples to get into a boat and go to the other side of the sea. Jesus went up on a mountain to pray by himself. That evening, the boat was far from the shore when the wind started to blow. Big waves tossed the boat up and down. Jesus was still on the mountain alone. In the middle of the night, Jesus walked on the sea toward his disciples. When the disciples saw Jesus, they were very afraid. "It's a ghost!" they cried. Jesus spoke to them right away. "It's me," he said. "Don't be afraid." Jesus' disciple Peter said, "Lord, if it really is you, tell me to come to you on the water." So Jesus said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat. He started walking on the water toward Jesus. But then Peter saw how windy it was, and he was afraid. Peter began to sink into the water. "Lord, save me," Peter cried. Jesus reached out and grabbed Peter. "Why didn't you trust me?" Jesus asked. They got into the boat and the wind stopped. Everyone in the boat worshiped Jesus. "You really are the Son of God," they said. Jesus showed that we can trust him. His life, death, and resurrection showed that Jesus is who he says he is. When we look to Jesus and trust him, he will save us from our sin.
Summarize the Bible story for today. Jesus' disciples got into a boat to cross the sea while Jesus went to pray. In the middle of the night, he walked on the water to the boat. Peter started walking on the water to Jesus, but he started to sink when he started to worry about the wind. Jesus rescued Peter. The story point for today is that Jesus walked on water. To start your discussion at home about this Bible story, here are some questions. What was unusual about the way Jesus walked to his friends? What happened when Peter started looking around instead of at Jesus? And how did Jesus show that we can trust him? Go ahead and hit pause so you can discuss. And now it is time for Missions Moment with Mulberry, the part of the show where Mulberry comes out and does a Missions Moment. Missionaries use many different kinds of transportation when they travel to tell people about Jesus. So as we watch this video, count the ways that missionaries travel.
Whether cruising down highways in some of the world's largest cities or bumping along dirt roads to get to hard-to-reach villages, a missionary's daily commute can look very different from typical transportation in America. Here are some of the ways missionaries get around the world. Boats. In the Amazon jungle, dugout canoes facilitate trade and maintain communication between villages and cities. One journey can last 3 days or 3 weeks. Nevertheless, it is the only mode of transportation to further the gospel, said a missionary in Brazil. Metros. Light rail is commonplace in commutes for missionaries in the world's megacities. Metros are usually crowded, so riding the metro can be an exercise in letting go of personal space. Trains! In some locations, people spend days on the train to reach their destination. As missionaries roll across the countryside, children play with newfound friends, people swap stories, and the conductor sells ice cream. In India, the railroad is one of the country's most efficient modes of transportation. Cars. Cars are popular among the middle and upper class in South Asia, but there are a few major differences when driving a car in these countries. Missionaries must master the skill of driving on the left side of the road. Some roads are full of ruts and potholes. During the rainy season, some villages are completely inaccessible for months at a time without a four-wheel drive vehicle, said a missionary in Southeast Asia. Buses. Until recently, owning a car was too expensive for most East Asians. For the lower and middle classes, buses are affordable and accessible. In Kenya, matatus are brightly colored buses or vans operated by private owners. These vehicles are decorated with bright colors and unique decorations to get the attention of potential customers. Trucks. Trucks are a common sight in sub-Saharan and North Africa. Some missionaries serve where seatbelts are only a suggestion, and riding in the back of a truck with 14 of your closest friends is an acceptable mode of transportation. Motorbikes. Motorbikes are a useful and inexpensive means of transportation. According to a worker in South Asia, motorbike drivers go anywhere on the road they want. Sidewalks, ditches, and in between cars. Another worker in Southeast Asia confessed, "Seeing multiple people on a scooter at once always makes me smile." Bicycles. Missionaries often have the opportunity to learn to balance groceries and sometimes kids as they ride through some of the biggest biking cities in the world. Missionaries in Europe say that as a result of biking, they've had conversations with other cyclists, and there has almost always been a chance to talk about Jesus. Animals. Some missionaries work with people who use more lively forms of transport, like donkeys or camels. Camels were created to survive with little water and food, making them a great choice in rugged, dry terrain, even if they do spit sometimes. Donkey carts can still be seen in many sub-Saharan African, Central Asian, and European villages. No matter the transportation, missionaries all over the world pray that God will place people in the seat next to them who need to hear about Jesus.
Did you count all nine? That was a lot of different ways that missionaries travel. Let's take a moment and pray for some missionaries now. Lord, we ask that you would keep our missionaries safe as they travel around the world. Please provide them with the money that they need to travel to tell people about you. And we pray that they would have many opportunities to tell people about you. In Jesus' name, amen. Our verse for this unit is Psalm 40, verse 5. Many, Lord my God, are the wonders you have done, the things you planned for us. None can compare with you. Let's practice our memory verse by singing with Miss Megan.
Thank you.
Good practicing, everyone. We're going to sing a few more songs now. Let's sing Father Abraham and Dancing on the Waves. Go ahead and stand up so you can dance along.
Come, we will trust in you. God is good, God is great. When the storms come in, we'll be dancing on the waves, sing and laugh. That's why we educate, to elevate, to motivate, make moves to appreciate, communicate as we celebrate, to sing.
I can do all things through Jesus Christ in me. I can do all things through Jesus Christ in me.
As we close our time together in prayer, thank God for what you have learned. Encourage each family member to share one thing they are grateful to God for and one thing they would like to ask God for. And take a few minutes to consider who else your family can pray for, especially those who do not know Jesus. Go ahead and hit pause so you have time to pray. Thanks for being with us for Sunday School again. We hope you guys are having a great week.